ऑलराइट, वेलकम टू येट अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ स्पॉट बॉय पॉडकास्ट। मेरे साथ हैं आप लोगों की चहेती एंकर्स संज्ञा लखनपाल एंड श्रिया पारिक।
हेलो
हाय गाइस।
और आज हमारे साथ एक बहुत स्पेशल गेस्ट मेकिंग हिज ग्रैंड डेब्यू ऑन द पॉडकास्ट, मिस्टर कैलिन वाज। नाउ लेट मी टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट कैलिन वाज। ही इज अ मास्टर ऑफ हिंदी, ओके, एंड दिस गाय कंज्यूम्स बॉलीवुड फॉर ब्रेकफास्ट लंच एंड डिनर। ठीक है, मतलब वो जो टिपिकल जो वो हिंदी होती है ना, वो अमिताभ बच्चन और लाइक वो पीयूष मिश्रा टाइप की वैसी। सो कैल, आई'ड लाइक यू टू मेक द ओपनिंग कमेंट एंड जस्ट से हाय हेलो टू द ऑडियंसेस इन शुद्ध हिंदी।
पर हिंदी में बोलना पड़ेगा,
कम ऑन।
नमस्कार देवी और सज्जनों, मेरा नाम है कैलिन वाज।
दिस
that was it.
So clearly a master of Hindi, and then from one master to the other master, sitting to my right, the handsome dude of Spot Boy, the guy who gets to see all the movies before they even release, basically the encyclopedia of Bollywood at Spot Boy, Mr. Vicky Lalwani.
Hi, thank you for having me here.
Vicky, आप देख रहे हो first episode से लेके अब तक जो betterment आया आपके introduction में, like from Kapil Sharma to handsome hunk. I think it's gonna get better because this is Friday and everything is good on Friday. Everything looks so fun on Friday, which is why this is our movie review podcast special. And here we pick out a movie which is trending all over the week and we discuss that because Vicky has already seen the movie. So, aaj hum baat kar rahe hain kiski? Veere Di Wedding ki. Starring Kareena Kapoor Khan, isme hain Shikha Talsaniya, isme Sonam Kapoor bhi hain and Swara Bhaskar. And interestingly, it's produced by two power women of the industry, Riya Kapoor and Ekta Kapoor. So it's only fitting, I guess, that we have amazing female panelists on the show today. So it's fitting that they moderate the session today. So Sangya, how about you take over?
Sure. So Vicky, आपने movie तो देख ली है और हम बैठे हैं यहाँ पे सिर्फ trailer देख के। तो मेरा सबसे पहला सवाल ये है कि क्या ये प्यार का पंचनामा female version है?
नहीं, I don't think that. I think it's a proper story of four friends. There is no male bashing, if that is what you're trying to ask me.
Of course,
there is
part of it,
there is absolutely no male bashing. इसमें ऐसे कुछ नहीं है.
अच्छा.
And they all have issues about, I think, which every girl has today. That should I get married or should I not get married? Whether it's Kareena, whether it's Sonam, because the one of the girls is in a bad marriage already.
अच्छा.
So even Swara is running away from, you know. Marriage year, so that's the focal point.
So talking about Pyar Ka Panchnama, movies which celebrate brotherhood and sisterhood. So obviously there's a comparison to Pyar Ka Panchnama, and remember vividly about this incident when Pyar Ka Panchnama had come out, and obviously everybody had seen the trailers, everybody had seen that infamous, you know, that monologue that Karthik Aaryan goes on, and the movie had come out. I'd gone with my girlfriend at the time. Big mistake. Because what happens is that when you go for such movies, you know in the back of your mind that there's going to be a lot of girl bashing, which your girlfriend or your partner is not going to be, you know, happy about.
Yeah.
And you can't laugh at that moment.
Yeah.
Because you stand at the risk of losing out on sex for a month.
Mm. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So at that point, everybody was going berserk in the amphitheater. And I was like, I was not moving a bone. Because I knew that what's going to follow if I laugh.
Mm.
And then the infamous monologue happens and everybody's like whistling, they're just going crazy and I couldn't move. So my question to you is...
So you didn't lose sex for a month?
I didn't, because I'm a smart person. Yeah, I weighed my options clearly. So my question to you is, now when girls go into the movie, is it a safe movie to go with your spouse, husband,
you can go with your spouse, but please don't...
And come out as a couple.
Yeah, yeah. There's nothing like that. Because, see, they are talking about, you know, ostentatious celebrations in marriages. That why are we, you know, chacha ke samne aisa kyun baat karna hai, mummy ke samne aisa kyun baat karna hai? Why are we to pretend? Why are we to fake is the, I think, the underlying line in the movie.
Hmm.
Why are we all the time faking it? Girls have to fake so much, you know, when they, especially during the time of marriage, during the time of their first meeting, during the time of
sex.
Their first few months at house,
you
know, with the elders. So that is bothering them a lot. And they also show a very important point that many lives have been screwed up by parents.
Yeah, true.
The children are growing up as maladjusted individuals or whatever, if you really take a cue from this, because of their parents. So it's not always the younger generation which is to be blamed. Their parents have had something to do with that.
Yeah.
So there are a lot of lessons to learn from this movie. But please don't go
with just your partner.
With just your partner is fine, or with just your friends is fine. because there is a very controversial scene of self gratification by Swara Bhaskar, and it lasts for,
right then,
and it lasts for good 15 seconds.
So okay. You're suggesting not to go with your parents?
Yeah, obviously. I thought it would be just like a blink and a miss.
हाँ,
1 minute, 2 minutes, 10.
फिर वो मतलब dinner table पे आप लोग आंखें नहीं मिलाओगे, फिर पानी लेने चले जाओगे कुछ. उसके बाद you're not gonna sit together as a family.
मतलब theater में भी phone निकाल के.
Suddenly मैं popcorn लेने जा रहा हूँ.
मैंने जब trailer देखा था, तो उसके अंदर जोर-जोर की गालियाँ and you know all these cuss words और ये सब. So do you think ये मतलब जबरदस्ती डाला हुआ है?
I am also very uncomfortable with these kind of words because I somewhere feel कि most of the time they are thrown in for the heck of it, especially in many indie movies, rustic movies. I think they are just thrown in. But here there's nothing like that. Even before that girl says the F word, you are saying it under your breath. So it's that.
So,
bringing the conversation back to women, I like to ask Sangya and Shri over here that in cinema, Hindi cinema, flawed men have been celebrated over and over again. Like Wake Up Sid, Man Child. But perhaps it's the first time that flawed, normal women characters are being shown, and there's no deliberate effort to show perfect women, which Indian cinema tends to do. So, are you guys excited to see normal women which you can relate to, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. Even when I saw the trailer, it begins with something like tu kiske saath soi ya, tu uske saath so gayi, and
that's
like,
did you sleep with him?
Yeah, you have sex with him, and it's just it sort of feels liberating in a way where you're like, अरे जो हम अपने दोस्तों से बात कर रहे हैं वो आगे दूसरे लोग भी करते हैं, and it's absolutely okay.
Very relatable.
Yeah, so I can relate to it. I can probably just feel like a part of the conversation sometimes. So it definitely feels good.
Also, like, you know, about this marriage and all these issues that happen and how they're dealing with their life in general. We only see good stuff on social media nowadays. We hardly meet so many people. हम लोग का आजकल सिर्फ छोटा सा सर्कल होता है और सबको हम सोशल मीडिया पे देखते हैं. Everybody is putting out happy stuff. It's good to see कि यार इन लोग को पता है कि असलियत में क्या हो रहा है, and they're actually showing it out there. Because आजकल कोई बात ही नहीं करता है असलियत की, सबको सिर्फ अरे वाह नाइस ऑल दिस गुडी गुडी स्टफ दे वांट टू टॉक अबाउट. सो इट्स गुड टू सी यू नो रियलिटी बीइंग पुट आउट देयर. लाइक
So you will relate to it, as
yeah,
I rightly
definitely.
Pointed out, because I met Ria yesterday and I had a long chat with her on this. So she, and I was tempted to ask her that, you know, it's so relatable that I'm sure that you have picked up instances from your real life.
Yes.
And she said that every scene, it has taken a long time for her to put this film together, but it has, every scene is from her life or her friend's life or some other person's life whom she knows. And essentially from her group, and when the group saw that movie, they said, yeah, I think it's me, but nahi, thoda exaggerated, but you know, they, is it really me? But they have immediately realized. And Ria also told me that she and Sonam together share this kind of relationship. The way they talk to each other is just this, because they don't hide anything from each other. They are so close to each other, the two sisters, and they talk like this.
So there's also one more part in the film where, you know, Sonam's mom is bashing the three girls. Okay, she's saying that one is has run away from home and she's gotten married, then one is getting divorced, and one is just
and she stands up for her.
Yeah, so she stands up for her. So, you know, this... So I don't think it's a bad thing to take your parents and go. To show them that, you know, this is the reality of what we go through as, you know, women and as teenagers, as a friends group.
Yeah.
That, you know, we go through these kind of problems and it happens. And it's fine at the end of the day. This is how we...
I think it's going to be hard for parents.
Yeah, I quite agree with you.
But I think it'll start a discussion.
Yeah, it will. It should, I guess.
Yeah.
It should be a kind of movie that, you know, you can go with your parents, watch it, and then you come back home and you can have an open discussion with your parents and say, yeah, this is what happens. And you can tell them.
Yeah.
It brings your relationship with your parents more open, more close also. And, you know, that builds up trust, I would say. So, yeah.
I think it's... Maybe we're going like too deep into the whatever. This is just like entertainment movie. Personally, I just feel
it's not gonna change a lot.
Yeah, it's not like a
but
revolution,
like,
but it might just resonate with some people. It might just some people might vicariously live through it. Some might some friends might start a discussion on it. But I just think it's a very fresh change.
Well, then my question is that if it's so relatable that it's about women and women can relate to it and women are celebrating, they're planning their weekend around it. Then why is this apprehension of calling it a chick flick? I mean, it's not a bad term. It's like terms like these have been celebrated by men also. Like men call a bro code and like a movie that bros will go and watch out. What is this? So also, a counter question to this is that it has taken a while to reach this level, to produce this kind of a movie, to make this happen. And in interviews, these guys have said that they've like fought a battle to make it, the movie, to get the monies. And now when you've gotten that money, kind of money, you've gotten that kind of influences, you've gotten Riya Kapoor, you've gotten Ekta, you've gotten Kareena, Sonam, everybody, such feminist icons, and then you're not calling it a chick flick. I know it might just make it a little frivolous, but Devil Wears Prada or Sex in the City, these are chick flicks or like girly content, but they have feminist icons like Meryl Streep. Then why is this shyness from using the term?
No, from the given interviews which we had with from the interactions which we had with Ekta and even Sonam and Kareena, it's the, what they were saying is that, you know, and they have been saying till now, that it's celebration of life. You know, it's celebration of life, pushing aside everything that is wrong and doing what is what you feel like from your heart. You know, girls have been suppressed, especially in our country, to a large extent, right from whether it's in school, whether it's in, you know, the timings are different for girls to reach home, there are various things, but they just want to be just like their male counterparts. So this is what they are, you know, trying to celebrate this time. So
also, I think, you know, chick flick, if you add that name, it makes a label. And people tend to judge, like, we don't, of course. All of us here might not. But I have friends who will not want to watch the movie. Even without watching the movie, they're like, ye kya hai, ladkiyon ka rona thona. I know people who will talk like that. Maybe that's why they do not want to call it a chick flick.
So there's a business sense also attached to it.
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, possibly.
I don't think so. Because, see, if you take fashion, Priyanka, Kangana, all these were walking on the ramp. Why was not that called a chick flick? So what if it was a female-oriented film, right?
Yeah.
So I don't think... I think this chick flick term got attached to Riya Kapoor somewhere in her earlier two movies. With Aisha and Khoobsurat.
Yeah.
And bas, haan, to Riya ne jitni picture bhi banayi hai, to chick flick hai. But Riya, in fact, the... yesterday's conversation, again coming back to her, she said, I will mostly make woman oriented movies unless I really have something to say with males which I want to send out a message across. So she said it that she will continue to make, she will continue.
I think every director draws inspiration from their own life, and she's a woman, so obviously she'll make women's
correct films. And each director has his own strengths, you know.
But again, there's another whole lot of other section which says that is feminism reduced to just a drinking, sleeping around and casual partying and casual sex? Now, I'm not saying it's bad. I'm saying that there are much more intense issues which, when you have influencers like these people, might as well tap into those matters as well. So, just from looking at the trailer, I think the trailer kind of makes it a little you know, frothy and a little frivolous, because they've only addressed sex and, you know, partying and stuff. Is it the only liberation that women need today? I mean, this is commonplace. What is not common is pay equality. What is not common is equal roles in a marriage. Is this something that the movie taps into? Or is it just about sex, drinking?
They have tapped into equal roles in marriage. I mean, if you take Shikha's...
Spoiler.
husband.
Spoiler,
and,
Vicky, please.
She. So that is one aspect of it.
So then it's not just boozing and sex and...
No. It's absolutely not. That's a misconception.
Then I guess it's the trailer which gives that impression.
Again, there are various, suppression to bahut tarah ka hai for women in our country, especially. So I don't think anybody in those 2 hours can tackle each and every point. I mean, if Madhur is taking up the fashion, he's talking about fashion. He can't go into other aspects, you know. If Neeja is about a brave act, it has to be about a brave act. It can't be. So this is about four friends who are, I mean, just at the age of marriage or whatever.
Figuring life out. Yeah.
Now, I was reading somewhere that after Baagi 2 and Padmavat, this is the third most grossing movie on the opening day.
Yeah.
Now, is it going to make life easier for women-centric films?
Yeah, and it is. They are saying the opening shows and the afternoon shows are more than Razi. I don't know the end figures kya honge, Razi ke kitne honge aur iske kitne honge, but in Plexus it has got off to such a rollicking start, I mean, which is amazing.
So I think, yeah, these actresses have time and again said ke jab hum wo numbers clock karne lag jayenge box office pe tab ye movies aapko milne lag jayengi. So I think in that respect everybody is loving the movie, they're watching first day, first show, and then all the shows are practically booked throughout the day.
Yeah.
So I think this is gonna turn the
I'm sure because I'll tell you, let's take the case of Kareena Kapoor. I know her quite a bit now since in the industry. She wouldn't have done a film with three other girls who have an equivalent role, parallel frame to frame, as a big star, and rightly so. I mean, there is a something attached to her which comes with her, you know, persona and style and everything. She has always made it, solo heroine, or I hardly remember except for those Karan Johar's multi-starers where you saw her in
Kajol or whatever.
Yeah. So she wouldn't have done this. She wouldn't have done this. And it's not that she was like dying to make a comeback or anything. She had a queue of directors and scripts on her table which she could have chosen. So there's something that, you know, has gone down with everybody in this movie. Whether it's Ekta Riya to hai, but even the girls who have worked in it. And they grab these roles.
I think women are the focal point in the movie. But what about the men? There is Sumit Vyas. He's a like gold mine of talent. But I was kind of disappointed by the character that he got in the, at least from the trailers that we have seen. It looks like an exact replica of what this guy played in the web series Permanent Roommates. He's going down on the knees, he's proposing the girl, girl panics at the last moment, the marriage is in, you know,
but now
in problem.
If you're asking me so much, then there's another spoiler here.
The task here is, without giving any spoilers, you need to elaborate.
No, so Kareena, I mean...
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler, nahi dena.
Okay. He's not a comic. He's not a cartoon.
Does he have that much screen time though?
Full. He's about a full. He's almost a full length role.
Oh, really?
Wow. He's, yeah. And there is nothing submissive about him or stupid about like this character. There's nothing. Maybe they just wanted to keep the stars like Kareena, Sonam, because obviously the story revolves around them. But there's nothing about that guy. In fact, he has a very big role.
Glad about that. And then as on a parting note, I just want to say that girl power versus superhero.
Hmm.
Who do you think is gonna conquer it?
Girl
power or superhero? Same family itself.
Yeah. Delicate question, but I think Veeray will be far ahead of Bhavish.
Powerpuff Girls. I think we have the verdict over here.
Final word, please go for it. Cal and Gaurav in particular, you won't lose sex for a month.
So jaise Vicky ne bola hai, please go check out the film. We are definitely looking forward to it. Parents ke saath avoid kare, partners, spouse, friends ke saath zarur jaye.
Parents ko akele bheje.
And just enjoy this weekend, enjoy the film. We are looking forward to it, and we will be back with another interesting topic in the next podcast for you guys.